众大家好，欢迎收看今天的黄金石油记者会，我是主持人张舒，现在正在纽交所的交易大厅为您带来本期的节目。我们看到周三美股下跌，在盘中标准普尔500指数是一度跌破了2100点的关键位置，而今天市场主要是受到了美国大选新闻以及包括美联储为期两天的货币政策会议的一个影响。在此次会议上，美联储决定保持当前的利率不变，但是市场普遍期待会在12月加息。但目前为止，我们看到联邦基金利率期货显示12月加息的可能性是高达70%，但是到目前为止，针对美联储是否加息还受到了一系列的宏观数据的影响。而在今天，我们看到有小非农支撑的 ADP 数字显示，美国10月份是增加了14万7000的职位，比预期要少。不知道这样子一个数字会否给美联储的加息蒙上一些阴影。但是市场普遍关注的还有本周五即将公布的一个非农就业数字。另外一方面，我们看到在上周五 FBI 重启对民主党总统候选人希拉里的一个邮件门调查事件之后，希拉里的一个领先优势就大幅度的缩减，而目前和共和党总统候选人特朗普是处于一个不分伯仲的一个状况。而这对于此前以及将希拉里获胜这样子的一个预期反映在资产价格的投资人来说，无疑是一个很大的承压因素。而这部分投资人也是在今天和最近一段时间都表现的并不是非常的良好。针对这一系列宏观经济因素，下面让我们来连线一下芝加哥商品交易所的交易员，来询问一下他对于黄金近期走势的看法。The uncertainties over the U.S. election and also Fed's policy meeting sent VIX rising 10% on Tuesday. Do you think there might be a cute long opportunity in gold before next Tuesday?
Well, from commodities, it looks like they are...reflective of the dollar, and I think also they've had a nice run. And I think with the equity markets backing up, I would expect to see commodity prices back up, except for gold. Gold looks like it did make some sort of intermediate bottom. Maybe it was, I think in the trend, it was probably a little farther than I thought, but a very good bottom, and we're seeing a nice spike off this. So I think commodities, with the exception of gold, look as though they have potential to fall, whereas I think gold has potential to continue to rally.
另外一方面，我们看到原油在周三是暴跌了3%，主要原因是最新一周公布的美国能源信息署上一周的原油储备是意外增长了1400万桶，而这样子的一个单周涨幅是创下了自12年以来的最大的一个涨幅，因此也是使得市场承压不少。而在这样的一个消息之后，很多分析师表示，可能美国的原油将在很短一段时间内回到40美元的位置。但是雪上加霜的是，欧佩克到目前为止不仅没能产生非常有约束效应的一个控产协议，相反，其成员国同样也是在不停的增产，而在10月份也是创下了3300万桶每天的一个记录，这使得市场的供求继续的恶化。那针对这一消息，让我们连线一下芝加哥商品交易所的交易员，来询问一下他对于原油的看法。
Ever since the OPEC announcement on September, Brent oil climbed by 10%. Do you think OPEC will finally reach a deal? If not, will Brent give up all the gains? How do you think about it?
I think that it does. It means crude's probably going to, WTI is probably going to trade down to 40. And, you know, once again, OPEC just simply cannot be trusted. Or maybe that's a little bit too harsh a judgment. OPEC...cannot be counted on to cut production because it's really going to all have to fall on Saudi Arabia, and it doesn't look as though Saudi Arabia really can afford to do that. So therefore, I don't think any production cuts from OPEC are really credible.
As we saw that the government data confirms the build in crude oil inventory, so we're going to see a slump in oil price. Then what's the supporting level to watch within this price range?
I think oil is at $40. I think you'll probably have a bounceoff of 44, but I think overall, before it's all over, we see 40 or maybe a little bit below. But at 40, I'm going to become a buyer, and I'm going to have the people that I know that want to hedge the oil start to hedge $40 as their price point, because I think that will probably be either at or near the low.
好的，以上就是今天的黄金石油记者会，我是主持人张舒，我们下期再见。